Silk is a valuable natural protein fiber produced by certain insects. Various insects like Lepidoptera in their larval stages and wasps in their adult stages produce silk as secretion from their salivary glands, Embioptera from tarsal glands, certain Coleoptera and Neuroptera from Malpighian tubules, and spiders and certain mites from their anal glands for making webs. The silk is used for construction of cocoons over the pupae, for making webs or silken tunnels for protected living under their cover, or for making nests by binding leaves and earth particles. Among insects, caterpillars of Bombycidae and Saturninidae are the important silk producers. However, silk is commercially produced employing the mulberry silkworm and eri silkworm. The silkworms of lesser importance are the tussa silkworm and the muga silkworm. The Chinese started sericulture are the science of rising silkworms. Though the discovery of the usefulness of silk is cited to Lao Tzu, the empress of K. Wang T, as early as about 2687 BC. It is being produced by Chinese. India has the unique distinction of producing all the four commercial varieties of natural silk, viz. Mulberry, tussar, eri and muga. Even now, Asia holds the monopoly in silk production, producing about 95% of the world's total output. Of this, 60% is produced by Japan, 15% by China, 5% by Manchuria, and only 1.5% by India. Pure silk is produced by Bombyx mori on mulberry leaves, while the other varieties of silk are produced Antheria milita duri, Antheria samensis helfer, and Samia cynthia duri, yielding tussar, muga, and eri silks respectively. Besides these, the hybrid strains evolve as a result of crossbreeding of a Chinese species, Antheria perni and Antheria proeuli, produces oak tussa silk. Coming to the mulberry silkworm, Bombyx mori. It belongs to the family Bombycidae. It is a totally domesticated insect and is never found in a wild state. It is the most important of all the silkworms and is extensively reared in many countries. In India, it is cultivated on mulberry in Assam, Bihar, Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, West Bengal, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Depending upon the number of generations per year, these silkworms are classified as univoltines, bivoltines and polyvoltines or multivoltine races. The univoltine races as a single generation a year, spending the remaining period of the year under hibernation as eggs, and the others have two or more generations a year. Univoltine race is found in Europe, Kashmir and Punjab, and the silk produced is of superior quality, and the multivoltine races is found in South India, Assam, Bengal, producing of inferior quality of silk. Coming to the biology of silkworm, adult moth is cream in color, about 2.5 centimeter long and sluggish. It lives for 2 or 3 days only. Mating takes place immediately after emergence. Each female moth lays about 300 to 400 brownish white seed-like eggs in masses. Hatching takes place in 8 to 12 days. The caterpillars on hatching are about 3 millimeter long and dark in color. They molt 4 times. The full-grown caterpillar is elongate, about 5 rn long, cylindrical, yellowish-white in color with a small anal urn. Larval period extends from 28 to 30 days. It produces a long cutaneous strand of silk to form a oval cocoon and takes about 1 or 2 days for constructing the same. Pupation takes place inside the cocoon and adult emerges in 10 to 12 days. Life cycle is completed in 6 to 8 weeks. The Central Silk Board, CSB, has brought out a system of authorization of silkworm races. Test rearing are done twice a year at 14 centers in the country, and silkworm hybrids authorized by CSB are exploited commercially in sericulture. Mulberry silkworm hybrids for different states such as Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, West Bengal, Jammu and Kashmir, and Uttar Pradesh have been identified. In India, over 95% of commercial silk is being produced is from multivoltin female into bivoltin male parent, that is crossbreed. The hybrid BL23 into NB4D2 is meant for rain-fed areas in Karnataka, and BL24 and NB4D2 is for irrigated areas in all seasons. Rearing package for the above has been developed by Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute, Mysore. Initiated breeding work for production of quality silk utilizing two Japanese commercial hybrids, which resulted in the evolution of highly productive CSR breeds. Coming to the non-mulberry silkworms, the Eri silkworm. This belongs to the family Saturninidae. The adult moth is taut and dark, and the wings darkish brown and white. It lays 120 to 200 eggs in clusters, which hatch in 7 to 10 days. The caterpillar has green body with a brown head, and the body has small tubercles bearing short hairs. The full grown caterpillar is 8 cm long, and the larval stage lasts for 17 to 25 days. The caterpillar feeds on castor leaves. It can pupate anywhere, so no chandrike is necessary. The cocoon is not compact but loosely spun. Silk is white or brick red in color and not as glossy as the mulberry silk. It is not in one single strand, therefore not reliable, and has been carded and spur like cotton. Since the thread is not a continuous one, the mass can be allowed to emerge from the cocoon, and after emergence the cocoons are reversed to remove the pupal cases. The cocoons are then soaked in cold water for 18 hours, in warm water for 45 minutes, washed in washing soda solution, dried and spun into silk. 28 grams of eggs will give you about 1600 larvae, which can yield 4 kg of silk after consuming leaves of about 0.5 hectare of castor crop. These silkworms are commonly reared in Assam and West Bengal, and can be successful in all places with good rainfall and warmer climate like Kerala, and where castor is grown. They cannot withstand severe summer. Coming to the tropical tussar silkworm Antheria milita duri. At present, 0.56 million hectares of forest is covered with tussar silk production, while an estimated 11.16 million hectares of forest land has been identified as eligible for cultivating tussar silkworm. Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Bihar, Karnataka and West Bengal have the food plants capable of breeding tussar silkworms. This is also a Saturninid moth usually found in forest areas feeding on Delbergia, Shoria, Terminalia, Jujubes, Ficus, etc. But the more important hosts are Shoria and Jujubes muritiana. Eggs are laid on tender leaves of the host trees, and a moth lays about 200 eggs. Egg stage lasts for 8 to 10 days. The caterpillars are stout, green with red spiracles, and the larvae period is 35 to 70 days. Pupal period is 25 to 50 days. The moths do not mate in captivity, and so the caterpillars cannot be domesticated. The silk is reliable, unlike that of the Eri silkworm, and therefore the pupae have to be killed before emergence of the moth to prevent cutting of silk thread into pieces. Coming to the Miga silkworm, the Miga silk moth, restricted to the northeastern states, particularly Assam, is semi-domesticated and multivoltin, producing a many as 5 to 6 broods in a year. The period of the life cycle may prolong from nearly 1 to 2 months in summer to about 3 months in winter. The larvae on hatching are yellowish, but as they grow, they turn into translucent green. On maturity, the larvae come to the tree trunk early morning for cocoon formation. and thus can be easily collected, unlike the Antheria milita. The cocoons are light to deep brown, but white is not uncommon. Males are reddish pink, females are lighter. The oak tussa silkworm is a temperate tussa silkworm represented by Antheria MME, Antheria royali and Antheria perenne respectively in Japan, India and China. The silkworm Bombyx mori is food to reptiles and amphibians. Silkworms are a nutritious part of any reptile's diet. Silkworms make tasty treats for any reptile because it is slow moving and comes in all different sizes. The worms in their second instar are large enough to be feed reptiles and amphibians. Silkworms contain less fat and most feeders, and they contain much more calcium, which is good for reptiles. Coming to the cultivation of mulberry plants, mulberry plants come up in any soil and in any climate. It is propagated by cuttings. The land is plugged well 6 or 7 times in April and May, manured with cattle manure at the rate of 20 to 25 tons per hectare. Furrows are opened in a meter apart either away, and at the junction small pits are scooped out and 2 or 3 cuttings are planted in each pit. Each cutting should be 20 to 22 centimeter long with 3 nodes. When the plants grow too high, they are cut back, and this will also help in the production of new flush or leaves. The plants can yield well for 12 years, after which they are pulled out and fresh planting taken up. From the plants each year, 6 to 8 crops of leaves are taken, and average yield per hectare is 25 to 30 metric tons of green leaves. Coming to the accessory required for successful rearing of silkworm are a bamboo racket to keep the trays containing the various stages of insect. Racks should have ant pans at the base of the stands. Many circular trays made of split bamboo for leaving the worms. Many bamboo baskets for fetching mulberry leaves. Chopping knife for cutting leaves. Chandrika or cocoon edge, which is a circular basket with a spiral wall about 5 cm width to facilitate the worms to attach their cocoons to them, and paraffin paper, brushes and foam pads. Transfer of the newly hatched larvae from egg onto the wax paper or rearing bed is known as brushing. In 4 into 3 tray, 50 DSLF means disease free layings can be brushed and reared up to first mouth and 25 DSLF up to second mouth. The egg sheet are distributed in required number per tray before hatching. Fresh, tender and succulent mulberry leaves with 80 to 85% moisture from a well-maintained garden are collected and chopped to 0.5 to 1 centimeter and spread over the hatched larvae and the egg cards. After 30 minutes, when all the worms have crawled on the leaf, the leaves along with the worms are transferred onto the paraffin paper on a rearing tray with the help of a soft feather and arranged in the form of a thin bed. Clean wet foam pads are kept around the rearing bed and covered with a paraffin paper to maintain the humidity. Pile ups trays one above the other in the form of a box to conserve leaf moisture for a longer period. In the case of loose eggs, 2 layers of cotton or nylon net is spread over them. After an hour, the worms along with the top net are lifted and brushed in a chalky tray. Rearing of engaged silkworms up to second mouth is called chalky rearing, which usually lasts up to 10 days. Under optimum rearing conditions, the worms take 2 to 3 days to settle for first and third mouth and 2 to 2.5 days for second mouth. Towards the end of the final instar, the larvae reduce consuming leaf, release wet fecal matter, shrink in size, body becomes translucent and start crawling in the bed with raised head. Such larvae are collected and mounted on bamboo or other types of mountages. Temperature of 24 degrees centigrade, humidity of 60 to 65 and good aeration are ideal for spinning. The cocoons are harvested on the 5th or 6th day after spinning. Double cocoons and flimsy cocoons are discarded. Mature coarse leaves are unsuitable for feeding as they do not give silk of good quality. The consumption of leaves by the caterpillars increases with the age from about 0.1 gram per day per caterpillar during the first stage to 5 gram during the last stage, and the total consumption during the entire larval life of a caterpillar is about 90 gram. Like quality, quantity of leaf to be fed depends on age of the larvae. It also depends on autumnism and season. Normally, engaged larvae feed less and the rate of feeding increases gradually with age. Bivoltine feed more than the multivoltine, and during summer feeding rate is high because of high desiccation and quick withering of leaves. Generally, 100 disease free layings, that is 40,000 eggs, require 2 to 3 kg leaves in the first instar, 6 to 9 kg for second instar, 25 to 45 kg for third, 75 to 120 kg for fourth, and 600 to 725 kg for fifth instar. Coming to the cocoon is made up of a thread of raw silk from 300 to about 900 meters, that is 1000 to 3000 feet long. The fiber are very fine and lustrous, about 10 micrometers in diameter. About 2000 to 300 cocoons are required to make a pound of silk, that is 0.4 kg silk. Coming to the silkworm breeding, silkworms were first domesticated in China over 500 years ago. Since then, the silk production capacity of the species has increased nearly tenfold. Silkworm breeding is aimed at the overall improvement of silkworm from a commercial point of view. The major objectives of silkworm breeding are improving fecundity, the egg-laying capacity of a breed, healthiness of the larvae, quality, quantity of cocoon and silk production, disease resistance, etc. Quantity of cocoon and silk produced is directly related to the pupation rate and larval weight. Healthier larvae have greater pupation rates and cocoon weights. Disease resistance breeding is important as the major reason for crop loss is pathogen infection. Efforts are being made to select breeds which are tolerant or resistant to various pathogens. Coming to the silkworm diseases, fungal diseases. This disease is caused by Bavaria bassiana, is a fungus that destroys the entire silkworm body. This fungus usually appears when silkworms are raised under cold conditions with high humidity. This disease is not passed on to the eggs from moths, as the infected silkworms cannot survive to the moth stage. This fungus can spread to the other insects. Coming to the grassery, if grassery is observed in chalky stage, then the chalky larvae must have been infected while hatching or during chalky rearing. Infected eggs can be disinfected by cleaning their surface prior to hatching. Infections can occur as a result of improper hygiene in the chalky rearing houses. This disease developed faster in early instar rearing. Coming to the pebrine, pebrine is a disease caused by a parasitic microsporidian, Nosema bombensis nageli. Diseased larvae show slow growth, undersized, pale and flaccid body and poor appetite. Tiny black spots appear on larval integument. Additionally, dead larvae will remain rubbery and do not undergo putrefaction after death. Nosema bombensis, a microsporidian that kills 100% of silkworms hatched from infected eggs. This disease can be carried over from worms to moths, then egg and worms again. This microsporidian comes from the food that silkworms eat. If silkworms get this microsporidian in their worm stage, there are no visible symptoms. However, mother moths will pass the disease onto the eggs, and 100% of the silkworm hatching of the diseased eggs will die in their worm stage. To prevent this disease, it is therefore extremely important to rule out all eggs from infected moths by checking the moth's body fluid under a microscope. Due to its miniature size and ease of culture, the silkworm has become a model organism in the study of Lepidopteran and Arthropoda biology. Fundamental findings on pheromones, hormones, brain structures and physiology have been made with the silkworm. One example of this was the molecular identification of the first known pheromone bombycal, which required extracts from 50,000 individuals due to the very small quantities of pheromones produced by any individual worm. Currently, research is focusing on genetics of silkworms and the possibility of genetic engineering. Many hundreds of strains are maintained and over 400 Mendelian mutations have been described. Another source suggests 1,000 inbreed domesticated strains are kept worldwide. One useful development for the silk industry are silkworms that can feed on food other than mulberry leaves, including an artificial diet. Thank you.